Seems like he's, I can see you feel like he's wasting your time and
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
You're losing precious time. Well,
yeah,
it also feels like, so how did you, so you said that he walked out and then afterwards you felt a little bit guilty.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? Like you,
yes,
you
yes.
said before, guilty, you felt like I should have said it a different way or something. Right. Like that. And so that first time before, when you didn't say anything, you kind of felt it, like you couldn't say whatever you wanted to say in that moment.
Right.
Well,
I think that when my emotions are too high, I don't really know what to say to him, and so I try to hold back, and then it becomes to a point where I lose control of what I need to, you know, my thoughts. And so I really wish I knew how to speak to him in a way that will address the issues before it becomes me, like, blowing off at him.
Okay.
But it's creating so much, you know, tension between me and him.
So the moment you, like, oh, yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
The moment there's a mistake, you feel a rush of emotions. Is that what you're saying? And it's, what emotion is the first one that kind of comes up? Like, a mistake's happened.
Like, frustration, like, come on, you're messing this up again?
Yeah.
Like, I think maybe that's okay. Frustration, right?
Frustration, anger, like you said before, okay. Well, let's try. We're going to explore this a little bit more. I'm going to ask you more about your emotions.
Okay.
If you're, if it's okay with you, I want to try something with you. It's called the empty chair technique. And basically, what I want you to do is, I want you to imagine that David is sitting in that chair right next to you.
Okay.
And I'd like you to, like, talk to him and say exactly what you want to say to him. You know, now, you know, you can, I suppose right now you're not angry right now. So say exactly what you want to say to him, exactly the way you'd want to say it. Maybe in that moment of finding out there's been a mistake, in the moment you find out there's, like, kind of been a mistake, you know, what do you want to say to him in that moment? So does that sound cool?
Yeah.
You want to try that?
I'm ready, yeah.
Okay, so. There he is, all right, there's David. I want you to just look at him.
Okay.
And I want you to say exactly what you want to say to him in this moment.
Hey, David, I can't believe you messed this up again. I don't want to get mad at you, but it's really frustrating for me that I have to keep going back and check what you've done so that I know for a fact that you have done it the right way. And it's really creating so much stress for me because, like, I'm not just doing my part, but I also have to do your part. And just getting to the point where I don't want to work with you, and I don't know what I need to do to, you know, salvage our work relationship.
Okay. Yeah. And how did that feel saying that to him?
It felt a lot better because first I don't have to feel guilty for like going off at him. But it also felt like I need to maybe explain to him more on what I mean by, you know, salvaging or like maybe fixing our work relationship.
Okay, well, let's try this. So now I'd like you to move over to that chair, and I want you to be David. You just said all that stuff.
Okay.
I want you to imagine like what David's response would be. So respond the way you think David would respond if you told him exactly what you just said.
Ashley, I'm really sorry. You know, although I've been in this company just as long as you have been, it's really, this is like a brand new line of work for me. I come from a different department, and I really haven't had the, I don't think I've had the right mentors to train me like you had, and I'm not doing it on purpose, but I don't know what to tell you other than the fact that, like, you know, I'm not doing it on purpose, and I wish I could learn so that you don't have to keep going back to check my work or, you know, waste your time and get this project finished. As a team, I don't want to make you feel like you're doing all the work and more because of my lack of ability, I guess.
Okay. And then how did it feel hearing David tell you that? Like, what do you feel when you hear that from David?
I feel that I need to give him a little bit more time or be a little bit
more time. What emotions do you feel, more specifically? What emotions are you feeling?
Maybe a little bit of guilt.
Okay.
It's also kind of comforting, I don't know, to hear that he doesn't resent me or that he knows that at least he's cognizant of, like, of his lack of, I guess, competency to do this project together. It's comforting, okay. But I also feel guilty because he did say, you know, that he's new in this position, basically, and he hasn't had the mentors or he hasn't had the trainings like I have been. I mean, I've been with this department since I started working, unlike him.
Okay. Well, why don't you go back? I want you to go back to your chair. So I want you to respond to what he just told you.
Okay. Well, David, I know that you haven't had the training or that, you know, you're new to the department, but that doesn't mean that you can continue messing up. There's got to be a point where you need to own up to your mistake and learn how to either fix your mistakes, get retrained, or change something about your way of work so that we can work together as a team rather than me having to keep checking back on you and impede our project. I'm not sure what needs to be worked on at this point, but I just know the fact that, you know, whenever I hear you talk about how you haven't had enough training or that you're new to the department, it just kind of seems like an excuse to me. And I think that's what frustrates me more, is the fact that instead of you just apologizing and trying to figure out what needs to be fixed, you spent more time trying to give yourself, provide excuses for what was done. And that's really, I think, where my anger comes from.
Okay. So how do you feel saying that? You just kind of said that's where you feel like your anger comes from.
I had no idea that my anger actually came from him giving excuses rather than making mistakes. All this time, I thought I was mad at him because he was so incompetent and not doing his job. But that was kind of an eye-opening moment for me right there, because I didn't realize I was more mad at him about giving me excuses rather than making mistakes.
Mm-hmm. So it's the excuses of saying, I'm just trying, and you had better training, whatever, that really, exactly, really made you angry.
Yeah.
Mm.
Wow, that's very relieving, because, now that I think about it, I'm more mad about him making excuses than him making mistakes. Because if he made mistakes and just own up to it, then we can kind of work together and I can show him what he did wrong. But because he's giving excuses, it's like, how can I, tell him what he did was wrong when he always has something to say to back up what he did was wrong? Does that make sense?
Yeah, sure.
So there's no learning opportunity rather than him just always talking about it. And I think that's why I think I get more angry, because I think there's no room for improvement. It's more like, I'm going to go this way while you do whatever you need to do, and I'll just disregard everything you say.
Mm. Yeah. So was this exercise helpful for you then?
Yeah, very much so, because all this time I'm like, I need to learn how to not be angry at him. I need to learn how to be nice. I need to learn to talk to him nicely, focus so much on let's be nice to him. But I mean, I'm not going to ever be nice to him, because now I realize, let me go back. Being nice to him isn't the problem. I guess the problem was me having to talk to him openly about, hey, David, it's okay that you make mistakes. I mean, I make mistakes too. But what I cannot tolerate is the fact that you give excuses, and that that creates more stress for me, and, puts me in a position where I don't even want to talk to you, because I feel like our conversation kind of gets focused on the mistake rather than solutions.
Sure. Do you think now that you've kind of found the words, through this little exercise, this a conversation you think you'd actually be able to have with David?
Definitely, because until now, I never was able to kind of put my emotions aside. I think I was very black and white, when I felt a little bit of emotion, I would just kind of put a wall and not even talk to him at all, to the point where, I couldn't control my anger anymore, and I just blew up on him. But now that I feel as if we're just having a conversation, I feel like I can talk to him more openly without, without just me going off at him.
Great. Awesome. Well, I'm glad that this helped.
Yeah. Thank you. I definitely want to try this out tomorrow at work, and, maybe for our next session, I can go over how the conversation went, and then you can help me out a little bit more. I'm sure I need more practice.
That sounds wonderful. Well, then try it out, and I will see you next week.
All right. Thank you.
Bye.